Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Land, please, the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I believe our last run would have been Blue Baby, because we won. So we're back around to Eve again. I mean, my reasoning might sound a little bit ridiculous if those of you didn't watch the last few episodes, but there's a reason I know that the next character is Eve. It's because I bunged up my cycle, not in like a gastrointestinal kind of way. 6N14C3NL. C3NL! It's my seed! As Eve, that doesn't make me feel that excited about it, but we'll see. So we can do this. Even if we don't get the cycle, all I want, my new New Year's resolution number 11, is just play well. Don't be afraid to take like another quarter of a second in making all of your decisions, and actually analyze the things that you're going to come across. Analyze your deals with the devil. Think, hey, I have a red heart container, but I won't have any red hearts in it. Will that deal with the devil kill me? Answer yes. Yes, it will. That being said, the last couple of runs have gone very well. And, you know, my batting average when it came to vanilla Isaac was only about, like, 50, 60% maybe. At best, two-thirds. Even over the course of this relative slump, I think I've been hitting about, you know, 75, 80% wins on the chest, which is acceptable, I think, for like baseline practice. But I really want to peak at the right time. You know, I want to make sure that I can actually rattle off some double-digit win streaks. Maybe not at will, but as soon as possible. Some people have suggested, you know, go back to normal mode to get the streak done. I don't think it really matters. I mean, normal mode, I guess, would be easier to have less of these asshole champions. But you know, I want to practice on hard mode, because then if it comes out that normal mode is how people prefer to play the game. You know, on a semi-competitive basis, not that I'm anywhere close to any of the speedrunners in the game, as you might, you know, guess from this room that we're encountering right here. Wow, that was not a good finish there. Then, you know, it'll be like I'll be Pavel Bure, who trained by skating with a parachute behind him to slow him down. This is a hockey reference for those of you. Ice hockey. Ice hockey, not field hockey. Why would you skate in field hockey? That's got to be probably against the rules, if I had to guess. So, doctor's remote. Doctor's remote is a bad item that can potentially do some good stuff for us, pretty much entirely for either killing a boss more quickly, because it will be like one epic fetus shot, which is pretty powerful, or for accessing a secret room. No keys, so even if there is a second area here that may be a library, we can't really justify getting it. Or, well, there's no second area anyway. I was hoping maybe a bomb would drop here so we wouldn't have to use Epic Fetus to look for the secret room. But I think instead of even looking for the secret room, we're just gonna, you know, one-shot Duke of Flies, see what we get. You know what? This early on, I'll take experimental treatment. It didn't ruin Whore of Babylon State. It did lower my damage. I think it also might have lowered my rate of fire. You know, that's not a very good start. You know, I think we're better off staying in the Whore of Babylon State. The one thing I will say, two things. Our speed is up. Whether or not that's a good thing is debatable, I suppose. But it seems like our speed is up, and of course we did gain 1 HP as well. With one bomb, we could access some stuff in here. And some stuff in there. I'm just hoping to have like, oh, this is our room, yeah. So all we need to do is survive one room, and then we get our doctor's remote charge. Alright, it's possible our damage didn't go down, and like just our shot size went down, although I think our damage went down. And this should give us pretty much a guaranteed deal with the devil here. We got two spirit hearts, which will allow us to preserve our Whore of Babylon state. And, you know, from things being not so fantastic, they've now turned out fairly nicely here. There's also another tinted rock in the top right corner, another easy one to miss because of the fact that it was kind of obscured by the map a little bit. Excuse me. You're not dead? I hate when these spiders take two hits to kill in the Whore of Babylon state. I think experimental treatment probably did turn out poorly for us there, but I'm glad we took it for the first time in a little while. I wish that item legitimately actually shuffled all your stats instead of just, you know, claiming that it shuffled all your stats, because that would make it more interesting than just like, well, it could fuck you, but probably not that badly. But it also can't really help you that much, so, you know, there's a lot of weird stuff going on with that. I can totally open that, and our tarot card is going to be the Empress. Was that worth a key? Because that and a charge of our item. You know what? I would say that it probably is. Empress card will make us even stronger, assuming it does work in conjunction with Whore of Babylon. And that could be something that might be a little bit important for our boss fight here. Although I would have to imagine that we don't have a great chance of taking a bunch of damage against our boss, no matter who it is. You know, even if it's the Haunt, even if it's Headless Horseman, we should be fairly fine here. So the D20 is a much better item than Doctor's Remote. But I'm going to stick with getting the charges on Doctor's Remote. Ooh, Burnt Penny, huh? We can get it. I'm going to stick with getting the charges on Doctor's Remote for now. I actually like Lucky Toe. Burnt Penny's fine. It might even be slightly better, but we'll have to sacrifice a charge for it, and I don't know. Does Lucky Toe actually give you luck up? That's fine by me. I'm going to keep Doctor's Remote for now, just to, you know, still crack open some useful stuff for us here. We might just use it right away against our boss, though. Let's see. Pin. I botched it. Oh, I didn't botch it. We can keep our Empress card. I might have rather just used my tears against Pin, and then we could have saved not Epic Fetus, but Doctor's Remote charge for unlocking some more of those like gated consumables back there, but whatever. Maybe we'll get the ability to fly here, and then we'll be very happy about it. Damage upgrade is something that we needed. This is why I did not want to use that Empress card. I didn't want to use that Empress card against Pin for no reason. You never know if you're going to be fighting Krampus right off the bat. Would I rather have D20 or Krampus's head? I think the D20 over the course of a run can provide a lot more value. But hopefully we just get Lump of Coal. Okay, good. We were going to go with D20 anyway, so this is totally acceptable. We don't want to pick that up. So we could drop that there and get something. Get that Burnt Penny, but I'd rather just look for the secret room here. And this will give us conceivably not what I was looking for. I was going to say conceivably enough money to maybe make our shop worthwhile. Conceivably enough money to maybe. Alright, it doesn't really work out, but you get the idea. I think we just end up taking the D20 then and leaving. We could use the D20 to reroll some stuff on this floor, but I don't think it's really that good. We're going to be saving it for maybe secret rooms. It takes 6 rooms to charge, so my philosophy with the D20, and I am like one of the least skilled D20 users you'll see, by the way. I recognize that I play very poorly with it. But... Oh, that's so good. That might be good. We'll see. I recognize that I am, and I try to work better, but I try to, you know, I consider the D20 kind of like feast or famine. So my philosophy is, if possible, save your D20 charge until you get like that perfect situation where you're in a blood bank or something like that, and you can reroll like 15 cents into 15 different consumables, and golden chests and, you know, trinkets and whatnot. Anyway, for now, we're content. Lump of Coal is helping out a little bit. There's no reason we have to get out of our permanent Horde Babylon state. Cat of Nine Tails, a slight damage improvement. Lump of Coal, a slight damage improvement. And above all else, quite a lot of Spirit Hearts backing us up for future deals with the devil. Spacebar item is okay. I would say okay at best. Paralysis, please don't be full health. Tears up, fantastic. Yeah, we don't have a blood bank coming on this floor unless we just get super lucky. So, I'd say we're in a pretty good state. I don't think D20 allows you to reroll live bombs anymore. Now, I might be mistaken in that, but I thought I used it. You used to be able to use like a tower card and then pop D20 and get like 15 rerolls right in a row, which was incredible. I don't think you have that capability anymore. Went to the right, popped out of the left. Seems legit. Thanks a lot, Curse of the Maze. That was kind of like I wouldn't necessarily say it was a next level tactic or anything like that, but it was a decent tactic that did work very well for helping. I mean, like, the thing with D20 is like, basically, you're just trying to reroll shit consumables into better consumables. So the things you want to reroll for the most part are pills you know are bad, tarot cards you know are bad, trinkets you're never going to want, and red hearts you don't need, or in our case would actually make our, you know, life worse. And individual pennies, especially if you don't need the money for the shop. But, you know, in generally speaking, it's worth re-rolling individual pennies because you could get either something better in a different category, or you could just turn that penny into a dime or a nickel. Even if it only works like 10% of the time, it at the very least you break even on it. Plus you have all the other, you know, consumables that you got anyway. So the big thing is maybe we don't spend money on this floor in the hopes of getting to an arcade on the next floor. And then that was not very good there. Then we just, you know, grind the shit out of that arcade. That's how people do it, right? Whenever I see breaking runs, it's always like... Where you at? There you are. Whenever I see breaking runs, they're always standing next to a blood bank, and I don't think that's just for, like, a fun posy type thing. I think it's like, you know, this is where I did my work. So this is gonna be a longish fight, you know, Horde of Babylon. I'm extremely lucky to have it, otherwise this fight might literally be the definition of ad infinitum. However, we are just going to continue here. And the best thing we can do is just maintain our composure. You know, the worst thing you can do against Mega Fatty is get impatient and, you know, start getting super close or something like that. We also have Horde of Babylon plus Lump of Coal, so we have decent range and we have the impetus or the motivation necessary to take advantage of that good range. I think he's going to jump. Oh, no, we got out of it. All right, deal with the devil? No. But we did get Jesus Juice, and Jesus Juice is yet another damage upgrade and another range upgrade, which is good. Because we could use both of those. Oh, we skipped over this big room. I was like, I thought there was something that should have been more harrowing over here. Harrowing, not the other one. I would love to go to the curse room on this floor. That's something that's on my bucket list for sure. Hate the knockback on these guys. Oh well, can't get that individual penny. This is gonna be a slowish run. We're already, oh man, come on. We're already probably only about 15 seconds away from what I would consider to be like the cutoff for having a good time or an average time at this point. And that's okay. It doesn't really matter to me whether or not we get the boss rush. Boss rush has been a little bit less useful for me lately. Hard to tell if that's like statistically it coming back down to the norm or if it is, you know, just some kind of unfortunate boss rush generation or something like that, but it doesn't really matter. Rubber cement, great item. Absolutely love it. Makes us look baller as hell. Full health is not what I was looking for there. So now, it would be really awesome if we could get a deal with the devil on the next floor, because without it, we're gonna have some significant problems. But, on the other hand, rubber cement does help out a little bit. At least we didn't get, like, you know, the poop in our item room followed by this. Lump of coal plus rubber cement also synergize well together. Could reroll these with D20. I mean, I haven't used the D20 yet, but I do think it's important to stack up this money for a couple of reasons right now. I don't know what I'd be hoping to reroll, to be honest with you. And I don't even want to look in this shop unless we get more money, because there's a spirit heart there, so I can't reroll this stuff as far as I'm concerned. And we'll use the spirit heart to, finance our trip to the curse room, I guess. Nothing there. And this floor's gotta be almost over at this point. There we go. A few pills. Do we know any of these are bad? Paralysis? We know paralysis is bad. Bad gas. Speed down. In the future, we can absolutely reroll those pills, as long as we... Oh, I picked up the wrong one. As long as we check them first. Coffee's still entering the bloodstream. Forgive me. I still think this is a good run, thus far. I'm not wasting my key to go to the shop, because I actually don't want to be tempted to buy anything. We could actually... it might be worthwhile to buy a spirit heart if they have one available. You never know. Let's check out our curse room. Yeah, you can just walk through this. Probably rather not. I appreciate the spirit heart, so we broke even on this room. Can't reroll spiders, as far as I'm concerned, so let's get a move on. And these guys are going to be annoying now that I have the, unfortunately, privilege or punishment of not being in the Horde of Babylon state anymore. Again, though, the rubber cement is going to be a very nice damage upgrade. Believe it or not, it's largely because of Lump of Coal. So it's hard to aim for, but if they ever get caught with like a shot off the backboard or something like that, they're going to end up being in a pretty rough time. Now that we have 16 cents, and we're presumably going to have a pretty good chance of getting a deal with the, an arcade on the next floor, and a deal with the devil, hopefully. My hope is that we come across a secret room that just has a bunch of money in it. We could maybe get two rolls then. One on our blood bank, because we don't need any more money at this point to continue getting blood banks in the future. And on our secret room, if we had like 9 cents, we could reroll the crap out of it. Curse of the Lost doesn't really matter to me. But this is a floor where I'm very much hoping for the opportunity to trade away enough HP to be in permanent Horde of Babylon state. Because, for real, I never want to have that full health nonsense happen again. I mean, mind you, now we'll know if a pill is full health, but still. This could be a secret room. Might as well check. If it's not, I'll probably just go to the curse room. Oh, it is. So now I want to... Oh, two charges on the D20 here. It could be good. Now I have to wait until we get another bomb. But it will save us a spirit heart, so I think it's well worth it. Our damage is actually... Like, I thought it would be a lot worse, but I guess we did just get Jesus Juice and, what am I thinking? I guess we did just get Jesus Juice and, Cat of Nine Tails, so it's It's not like we should be rolling on Eve's base damage, but I thought, like, the Whore of Babylon impact would be catastrophic when it left us, but actually, we're still doing totally fine here in terms of our damage. Like, a little bit below average, but certainly, like, as Eve, you really want to avoid those catastrophic situations where it's like, you know, your damage was good, and then you lose Whore of Babylon, and... Well, actually, the worst situation is when your damage is okay, and then you lose Whore of Babylon, and it's shit. I guess our damage with Whore of Babylon was actually pretty nice, so... Losing Whore of Babylon was like, alright, a temporary setback, but we can always get that damage back later. It's a latent damage upgrade now. Good stuff. Pretty easy room, all things considered. Still need to bomb. Still need to find some special rooms, if it's at all possible. Not really trying to engage in anything too funky here with, with the rubber cement, it's just doing its part. The keys are out of control. One more bomb wouldn't be the worst thing in the world, as far as I'm concerned. Still no special rooms. Wow, see, that was awesome right there. And it's actually, like, really nice to end up fighting enemies in situations like this, where they're kind of trapped in a corridor, because even if you miss a shot, you know, you could bounce one back, catch them on the rebound. So, like, Lump of Coal's not doing me any favors here, but we are, like, affecting the one at the bottom while we're shooting, so I don't really mind. You should be popping up, dog. There we go. Well, I would like to reroll that, but unfortunately we have no means with which to get it either. Help me. Okay, this is important. We're running out of Spirit Heart insulation, which is very bad for me. Ah, there's another bomb. So we'll go to our curse room before I forget where it was. And again, say goodbye to Boss Rush. This run is slowed way, way down. And that's A-okay. It was right here, yeah. We got very lucky that on a relatively big floor, our secret room is right next to the curse room. Ah, perfect. Two black cards. So that gives me a little bit more survivability, and I appreciate it a great deal. You want to, like, just take a look in other directions here to see if maybe there's something closer by? Because we've already hit a number of terminals. Good stuff. I shouldn't be trying to bounce the shots off the back wall. Rather just take the guaranteed slightly lower damage from hitting them right away. Please, God, give me some kind of special... Oh, we've looped back around here. I get it now. Okay. The floor's not necessarily as big as I thought. It was just, it looped back around in an unusual way. Rubber cement is kind of, like, weirdly, penetrative tiers as well. Like, they kind of, like, they hit and pass through, which is great, but... We finally got a chance to use it. I'm not sure if that was the best opportunity, but hey, we picked up more money and more of every single consumable and a spirit heart from doing so. I mean, that's really what you want from this. Now, I am a little disappointed that we finally used D20 and then literally on our next room found a blood bank. But hey, this blood bank could be a... Oh, shit. Could be an amazing get for us for what I think are some fairly obvious reasons here. We have the opportunity to get back into our Whore of Babylon state and just create a ton of money on the ground. And there's already another battery charge just sitting back inside of our secret room. Really? You're going to pay out that quickly? Well, I don't really want to pick up the HP upgrade, to be honest. I can't get out of this without picking this up. So I might as well take it, I guess, because I have to. And I'll take the money with me. That's very, very disappointing, though. I should have picked up that red heart before I went in, but I was like, ooh, I guess I couldn't have. I blew it a little bit. That's okay. Let's try to use some bombs in this situation here. We got Liberty Cap. A paralysis pill, so we can drop the paralysis pill. Speed down, we can drop that. We'll just put that in the pile of shame over here. Bad trip, okay. I mean, it's good to know that that's there. How about these two? Nothing out of these two. Well, that's where we're going to use our other reroll then. I know it's only going to be four things. I'm disappointed. It's not 100% my own fault, but I'm disappointed in that nonetheless. We still have not been to our item room either. At least we got something decent out of that first reroll. And we'll just take this back, and we'll reroll those four things. I realize that we're rerolling a trinket that I already had, but I think it's worth it just to make the reroll a little bit better. Of course, it's a crapshoot, you know, it could be bad, but we'll see. Wow, that was... well, I mean, we rerolled some pills into something that's actually useful for us, but apart from that... Ugh. Not the best D20 reroll you could possibly ask for. All this being said... We've had an okay floor thus far. Halo of Flies, well, not Halo of Flies, but Distant Admiration Attack Flies, pretty good. And this will be the end of this floor. Now, we, of course, won't have a reroll ready for our boss or our deal with the devil, but that shouldn't really matter all that much. Unless we get, like, the cardboard box or something like that, but, get the cardboard box, I'd probably just be happy to have the consumables, to be honest with you. So let's break these nubs that never come back. And then we're gonna... I bet the better way to handle this is actually to bounce these shots off the back. I don't know if this actually does more damage, but... It seems to me conceivable that it would. Also, we can stand a little closer, let Attack Fly do its dirty work. Look, I don't know if this is the right way to handle this, but it's kind of fun. And it's at least a little different. Come on. Yeah, deal with the angel! Oh, I guess we did fight Krampus first, so it really would have been awesome if we had our D20 ready. Maybe we'll get something in here. Oh, we got Godhead. Never mind. I'm not going to complain anymore. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. So we'll take our money and move onwards here, downwards here. Godhead, a great upgrade for so many different reasons. You probably don't need me to even mention them, which is good because I'm still not 100% familiar with them. But definitely homing tiers, definitely more damage. Not sure if it ups our rate of fire or anything like that. I guess we're coming back this way now, which is fine by me. I mean, I guess we might as well stack up as many HP upgrades as we can get, considering that I'm not going to be entering our Whore of Babylon state anytime soon, unless we get maybe like an IV bag or something like that. I think rubber cement plus homing tears is pretty sweet, because you can see like as these shots bounce, they just loop back around and hit again. So it's really just like shots that hit multiple times here, which is pretty awesome. For all the times that I complain, I recognize that I have very good luck, and there might not be a better example of my surprising luck than the frequency with which I have gotten Godhead, despite having only unlocked it fairly recently. Like, this item shows up for me so often that it makes me feel a little bit bad, because I see people, like, on the subreddit, and they'll be like, finally got Godhead, unlocked Platinum God, and the first thing I'm like is like, whoa. You know, how did you not get Godhead? Like, it shows up all the time for me, or at least, you know, once every, like, 10-15 runs, which is not all the time. It doesn't take a long time for me to find it. But then the second thing I ask is, how the hell did you get Cube of Meat, you motherfucker? Did you cheat the system? I bet you cheat the system. Maybe not, though. It does happen. My wife, Kate, actually got... She's gotten Meat Boy twice. Once, fourth level Meat Boy twice. Third level Bandage Girl once. Not quite the fourth level, but she's close. Game Kid's just not good enough. The first time she had Book of Revelations, the second time she just got super fucking lucky. And it was just like, I was like, really? This might be an opportunity for a reroll. It depends on, you know, what these pills are. You know, I'm just going to use the world card here so we can see where our secret room is. That way, if we get a good pill, we can take it with us. And these guys are going to be very easy to kill. We don't need any other damage upgrades now. It would be very nice, especially if we could just, like, get into the Whore of Babylon state by finding a random guppy's paw or something like that. Pretty fly. Lovely. Range up. Lovely. Paralysis. Not lovely. Health down. Not lovely. Bad gas. I'll take it with me. I can't really justify using our D20 to reroll this. And you might be saying, you know, that's too good to use syndrome, NL, and you're not wrong. That is too, that's like the definition of too good to use syndrome. I won't use my Phoenix down to resurrect somebody. It'll only bring somebody back to life once. I might as well save it, you know? But it's the philosophy that I'm choosing to roll with, for positive or negative. Battery, Spirit Heart. I mean, actually, the battery is a pretty good pickup if I'm suffering from too good to use syndrome, because it means that I can... Well, that's not worth rerolling as far as I'm concerned. I can actually store up multiple charges, which is good, because now too good to use syndrome actually becomes a bit more of an advantage. If we come across an arcade, we can have two rerolls instead of one. So we can reroll all of the shit on the ground. Oh, this is perfect. Do we know these pills? Tears Up's pretty good. Range Up's pretty good. And our tarot card, the Sun. Hey! That turned out pretty well there. We basically picked up a boss item. A Tears and Range upgrade. I guess it's not that incredible, but still... I'm happy to have it. Oh god, oh god, oh thank god you got further away before choosing to dissociate and then explode. Lucky me. Anyway, that was a pretty good reroll. But yeah, the battery, if you're not going to be using your D20, the battery seems like a pretty good pickup. For people who don't use their spacebar items, introducing the battery, a Cinco product. Now, again, damage is bad here. We should have a pretty good chance of a deal with the angel. I think we might have a good deal with the devil chance. Probably don't want that health downgrade. Should be okay without it. Hello.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
Kate, check out the item that I got.
Whoa.
You know what it is?
Funny.
What is that?
Firefly.
Looks like fireflies. She's not wrong. This is the Godhead.
Oh, shit!
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
Hallelujah.
I've already had it before, but it was lucky that it showed up on this run, because I ruined my Horror Babylon state with just a random full health pill.
What does it do?
State.
Why is it glowing?
So, it's like Sacred Heart.
Yeah.
It gives you better damage, like a lot better damage, and your shots home. And also, it's not just like the little nugget in the center that does damage. The aura around it does damage as well. So it really stacks up like pretty nicely. Plus, I have rubber cement right now, so the shots just never miss.
Oh my god.
Alright, so this is like the moment of truth for this. Maybe we can get into Horror of Babylon state and be able to use our D20 once or twice here. This would be awesome. The question becomes, would we rather be in Horror of Babylon state and... Oh, we can't actually use Bad Trip effectively here, so... I don't think this is that bad of an idea. Okay, so I'm gonna blow this up. And that's gonna blow up some other stuff, and I'm gonna blow this up. And I know that we maybe could get something out of this, but I'm gonna blow this up as well. And then we're gonna re-roll the crap out of it. Okay, wait for the bombs to explode. Open the red chest. Spiders. That's better than an individual penny. Maybe, maybe not. I can't really say with certainty that we did better on this re-roll. But we got some stuff. I don't want that heart. Don't take that heart. Speed down. Oh my god. Range. Okay, we got a range upgrade. All things considered, I'm a little disappointed in that. See, I need to take like a lesson from like a... Well, we could reroll that again when we get it. But anyway, I need to take like a lesson from a really good rebirth breaker and then figure out how to use the D20 effectively. Like the mind is willing, but the body is willing, but the mind is just, you know, not up to the task, I suppose. Could so easily take damage here. I can't see shit. The Godhead does have a little bit of a visual effect that can be, you know, slightly disorienting. Now, you might be saying, blow up those skulls. They have the chance to pay out with consumables, and then you can use those consumables as reroll fodder. But I really don't want to do that, because the skulls pay out with great things. But I don't need any more great things. I've already got some great things in the form of the sun here. This is Necropolis 2. I didn't realize that we'd sped up that much. Honestly, missing page 2, I mean, I guess it's good, but I almost don't take it on principle. That principle being, I don't know what it is and I'm afraid of the unknown. Broken stopwatch. I mean, we should take 9 volt. That'll give us a full charge, and then if we dislike our reroll again, we can come back and get another charge. But I think apart from that, we're pretty much just gonna head straight into the boss room here, and this should be a one run. So we got like a red patch out of this, and a couple of bombs. You know what? Fuck that. I'm getting my charges. Alright, we're going back. Now, I think the D20... I might be mistaken on this, but I think the D20 loses a little bit of its effectiveness. After we get past the point of the game, in which there are no arcades anymore. Actually, we can still get arcades late in the game, now that I think about it. Let's pop you. We got some more pills. Bad gas. Pretty fly. Hey, well, we did it all for the pretty fly. That's okay. I mean, we'll still hold on to it. Actually, we should go to our boss trap room now. Never know if maybe we'll get Guppy's paw or something in there. I think maybe, like, one of the things that's... Oh, we got Guppy... Oh! Whoa. That's really good. Like, really, really good. I think we'll probably end up getting rid of the D20 to take Guppy's head with this, because our damage is so good. Did you see how quickly we just killed those bosses, by the way? But this is excellent. Okay, we just got 2/3 of the Guppy triumvirate. It's going to be unlikely that we get the third, but we should explore the rest of the floor just to maybe go into a curse room or something like that. You never know if that might be the exact thing we need on this run. Oh, you guys are screwed. Normally this room would be like super annoying. Instead, pretty easy. There's our curse room, so this is the whole reason I did this exploration down here. Alright, well, I mean, it was worth it somewhat. But yeah, this run is... borderline straight up one already. Especially if we can get a deal with the devil. I'll get that chest, don't worry. Especially if we can get a deal with the devil, and especially if that deal with the devil has a Guppy item in it. Or we find some way to keep us in permanent Horror Babylon state, which is still, you know, wrecking me right here a little bit. But anyway, this has been a great situation here. I think one of the impetuses or one of the motivations to do well with the D20 is by getting an early, like, bloody penny, or, now that I think about it, an early burnt penny trinket, so that every penny may be paid out with another consumable that you could pick up the money and then reroll it, but I don't know. I think bloody penny is probably the more kind of requisite common one. Should really watch some breaking runs at some point, you know? Instead of just, you know, being stuck in my ways here. No deal with the devil. Or angel, for that matter, but we'll take the Polaroid and we'll move along here. You know, we maybe should have taken the dark room so that I would have had the opportunity to, or an increased opportunity, at least, to maybe get a guppy item. But what's done is done. Yeah, let's open it up. Demon Tail, I think, is totally acceptable. I still don't fully 100% understand its, the way it works, but that's okay. I love the fact that, like, normally when you have really high damage shots, you see the health bar go down and kind of like tick, 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 tick. Nice. Ours is actually going like, just like a constant stream of HP removal, which is awesome. So I think the thing with Demon Tail is that it makes it so that other hearts have basically no chance to drop, which is a negative depending on which character you're playing as and what items that you have. Like if you have the relic, for example, I think maybe it doesn't pay out at all, or maybe it has a diminished chance to pay out or something like that. Same with Little Chub. But that's great for us because I really don't want any other kinds of hearts. I mean, black hearts are the best. There are times, like I said, situationally you might prefer to not take Demon Tail. But I really, really don't want red hearts. That's like the biggest thing that we've got going in our favor thus far. It should be hard for us to lose our Horror of Babylon state. Unless I get Curse of the Blind, actually, is what I was thinking. Oh, come on. Hey! Hey! Permanent Horror of Babylon state, and we became Guppy. Oh my god, this damage is going to be incredible. What do you got? I'm not going to take it. I'm sorry. I can't take it. Sure, it might be Magic Mushroom, but if it's an HP upgrade, then it'll ruin my Horror of Babylon state. I can't do it. We're much better off in the situation that we're in right now. And this is going to be... I know I say this a lot, but I think this is going to be among the highest... you know, damage-dealing runs I've ever had in my entire life, and that is always exciting. This is Curse of the Unknown, not Curse of the Blind. Curse of the Blind didn't inhibit us all that much on the last floor. You can tell I'm getting excited. My voice is cracking a little bit, but, like, in all sincerity, we made out like a bandit. Though, I think we made a really good decision. Nah. I think we made a really good decision choosing not to take that boss item. I don't know what it is. I mean, you saw the seed at the start. Maybe you'll pick it up and tell me what it is. But either way, like, you know, why risk a one run by taking something that could make your life worse and is not silly? Like, if we got, I don't know, Isaac's Tears or something like that, I'd probably take it. It could be silly. I probably would not take it now that I think about it. That's ridiculous. I got Guppy's head. Why mess with greatness? I know there's a chest back there. Who am I trying to impress at this point? Are you seeing this shit? All we need is, like, a Mom's Knife Brimstone, and then this one's in the bag, if it's not already in the bag. What do you think? I think instead of our Sun card, I think I'm better off having a Purthrow rune that I can use to reroll our chest items. I think it's a good idea. Hopefully we don't end up with Curse of the Blind on the chest. That's one of the more frustrating... I mean, it's always a little bit silly to get it, but that's one of the more frustrating, you know, options, unfortunately. I'm imagining Mom's Heart is going to be pretty quickly dispatched here. Rest assured, by the way, I am conscious of the fact that we have become Guppy on, like 80% of our winning runs lately. But I can't argue with the... We might as well use one Sun card to see where we're going. That's a good point. I can't really argue with the meta of the game, you know? If the game gives me Guppy, what am I supposed to do? Make Guppy aid? No, I'm going to pick up the Guppy items. I don't really care about the secret room, to be honest with you. Not until we get the Meat Boy... unlock so I can actually have a good chance to pick up raw liver or, you know, other items of the sort. I have, you know, some items people are commonly asking about. I have picked up Black Lotus. I'm pretty confident that I picked up the 1-up. I could check, should check, to be honest with you. But mostly I just like playing the game. Very good. So this, oh, Tinted Rock over here. It is looking like this streak will go up to 3, and we'll be playing as Samson. You know, this is the slightly more dangerous corridor of the game, in my opinion. If we beat Samson, then we play as Azazel. That one's usually relatively easy. If we beat it as Azazel, we play as Lazarus. That one might be the trickiest, but it does depend on how well we do as Eden, who is the one after Lazarus. But I'm feeling pretty confident in our chances right now. Mostly because this run is just the ultimate confidence boost right now. Curse of the Lost. HP is not amazing, so let's not get overly cocky on this run yet. Our damage is amazing. Our HP is leaves a little bit to be desired. We do have 9 lives, though, so that should carry us, even if things go terribly, terribly wrong on this life where we have a lot of HP. Plus, Perthro Rune on the chest. It's advantageous. You got a bomb item for me? Ugh. Mr. Boom. We'll throw down this Judgment. We'll play him. Odds are he pays out with an HP upgrade. I would rather he didn't. Maybe just give me like a Spirit Heart. Ah, you idiot! You idiot! Paid out with a Golden Chest. That was the worst Judgment of all time. Not only did he pay out with a Troll Bomb, but it wasn't like he spat it out. It would just like appeared inside of him. There was no time for me to get it out of the way. Two of Spades? Well, all of our key situations are going to be sorted out for us, no problem. I don't see any Tinted Rocks, but we did pick up a black heart there. Thank you, Demon Tail. That could have been a Spirit Heart, but it probably would have been a red heart. So I appreciate the transformation there. Sometimes I'm forgetting to use Guppy's Head, but it doesn't really matter because with the battery, I can actually store a couple charges. What? You dropped a red heart. Maybe because you're a champion, you had no other option. I understand. Your hands were tied. Look, I'm not going to be mad at you about it. That's okay. Well, one thing's for sure. I am extremely glad that I did the exploration necessary on that last floor before I fought Mom's Foot. I don't like calling him Mom's Foot. That's just Mom, you know. She's got other body parts. She's not just a foot to me. She's my mother. Austin! That's my mother! We can fly already, and we don't want the HP upgrade, so put that in your pipe and smoke it, basically. This is our boss fight. I expect this is going to be pretty, pretty easy. I love rubber cement and then, like, powerful homing tears. They hit, they bounce away, and they come back. And with Lump of Cold, they come back a little stronger than they left. This is good stuff. Oh, I'm loving that HP removal right there. Good effing bye. All right. Very, very, very easy fight. All we have to hope for here is no Curse of the Blind, and then we're sitting pretty. Chest. No Curse of the Blind. No curse at all. Decent. It's okay, but we're not going to use it similarly. Okay, we'll definitely take Spider Bite. I think we'll take Fear Shot just because it's a cool tier effect, and then we'll reroll the rest. We get Scapular and Ares. Neither of those items are bad, but if we get another Perthro Rune, I wouldn't mind rerolling them, because I don't think they're going to provide us with much benefit. So Technology 2 allows us to continue firing while also having some sweet-assed technology lasers. Now, it might lower our damage, admittedly, but we also get sweet-assed technology lasers. Apparently, we have a chest. Oh, yeah, we will absolutely take advantage of that. How many keys? We have a lot of keys. All right, let's pick up all our passives then, and we'll start using Unknown, Undefined. So our passive items up here, not... Oh, they're both passive. Okay, yeah, we'll take this. We'll take this, and let's have some fun on this run. Hopefully this will just work right away. Hey, it did. Okay. So we get Joker, Emperor, Chariot, Two of Diamonds. Pop Two of Diamonds. Pick up Remote Detonator. Put it back down. Head up to the next floor. You get the same layout. I'm not sure if we'll have a curse or anything on this one, though. Good, no curse. Maybe that's normal. Chocolate Milk. Isaac's Tears. Well, time to put your money where your mouth is, right? Inner Eye for Triple Shot. Really low rate of fire. How does this work with Chocolate Milk? Could be great. Anyway, we'll take a Book of Revelations. I'll try Isaac's Tears out. I doubt it's any good. Plus, it's a spacebar item. I might want to, like, try this out on one room just to see how much damage it does. It actually seems pretty nice. Like I guess Chocolate Milk, Isaac's Tears is a pretty good combination. But I'm not going to roll with it because we need to roll with Undefined. Tough Love. I'm not sure what our luck stat's like, but anyway, that's okay. We'll take Undefined, and we'll pop our Joker card. Joker card gives me a chance at a Book of Belial. We'll take Contract from Below, though. We can't take Book of Belial because we need to maintain our spacebar item as is. So I don't know how much damage our triple shot is doing. Answer, it's doing a lot of damage. And with rubber cement, like, stuff isn't really bouncing anymore. They're kind of just staying still. But that's allowing them to do a lot more damage, I think, which is great. And of course, we have, like, infinite range technology helping us out as well. This run has the capabilities of getting extremely strong. Yeah, well, we basically one-shot war. Come on. Give me some more treasure chests. One-shot chub? Not quite. Oh, we get... I didn't even realize, but we basically have the spoonbender effect on our technology laser, thanks to Godhead. How could I not notice that? I guess I got a lot of other, you know, stuff going on this run. It's a pretty incredible one. Actually, rubber cement is doing its part. I appreciate that. All right, two keys. That is Eve versus Greed. Doesn't really bother me. Oh, two golden chests. Blood rites and Virgo. Virgo gives us the PhD effect, at least. You know, blood rites not something I'm too interested in. Good run, though. It's like the most powerful tiers we've ever had at such small a size. Very happy we have 9 volt going on this run, so we have the opportunity to, you know, get our charge up as soon as possible. Only 2 more rooms until we see if we can continue the ridiculousness that is this run. One day it'll have to end, but it doesn't have to be right now. Sagittarius, yeah, I think it helps. And my best friend, which is not very good at all. With contract from below, we shouldn't have to worry too much about running out of keys. And notice I say too much, because I don't know. Ah, there we go. It's the error room again. 2 of diamonds, sure. Get another Joker card. Are these all the same? Yeah, Chariot, Emperor. Take portable slot and then put it back down. And we'll head up to the next floor again with 17 keys. So we got pretty strong on that floor. Let's keep it going, basically. I'm looking for Polyphemus, Proptosis, stuff like that. $3 bill. Good. Yeah, good. Is that an HP upgrade? Even if it is. Yeah, it is, but it doesn't give us red hearts, I guess, unless we start with red hearts. So that's a decent haul. Let's trade away, like, all these spirit hearts we got at a deal with the devil. For Dark Bum? Why not, right? And let's continue onwards. Do you always get the same format of error room? That would be, you know, slightly not amazing, but it's okay. And we always get, like, the same enemies. But that doesn't really matter all that much to me, because we didn't encounter any super tricky rooms recently anyway. So who cares? It means we will fight Greed in our boss room. I don't know if Greed will drop the same thing, though. It would be nice if we could get 2 more chest drops from that. And we just continue getting stronger and stronger as time goes on. This is an ideal Eve run. We could finish it any time, but we're going to choose not to just because of how ridiculous it is. I'm really liking, like, piercing shots, rubber cement, how they just, like, bounce... Oh, I didn't even pick up the keys. I didn't pick up the keys! I need the keys! That was so dumb. We should get more in the future, though. But anyway, we got Guppy's Paw, and we picked up 2 of diamonds and a Joker card. So we do get, like, the same layout every single time. That's okay, though. That's all right. Let's see what we got in here. Still got enough keys. Book of Shadows. Books, books, books. Wow, that is a terrible haul. Not that interested in this stuff. The definition of a Perthrow-worthy chest right here. That's okay, though. Let's take our Joker card. What do you think? Take Brother Bobby? Yeah, I think we'll take Brother Bobby. We're not gonna die! Like, we're fighting the same enemies every time. It's Groundhog Day. And we have the Miter, so we're gonna pick up HP in the process. Oh, you know what? We might want to drop Demon Tail now. Demon Tail might make it hard for the Miter to pay out with Spirit Hearts. Which might be one of the very few things that could conceivably kill me on this run at this point, is, you know, doing something very silly like that. Other things I need to keep in mind. We should definitely pick up all of the keys that drop. Even if I only get 2 keys per floor, that halves the rate at which we find ourselves unable to open more chests in the future. Oh, thank you. Plus, with Dark Bum, I guess we should not have the Demon Tail so that Red Hearts can drop as well. I need keys, though. Ah, Speedball. Obviously, there'll be a Joker card associated with this. We'll take Speedball. We have 9 lives, so we can do this, like, forever, basically. Seems like I've found the pattern that just consistently gives me the error room. Okay, X-ray goggles, crack the sky, Monstro's lung, PhD. Nausea, heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea. Yay, paralysis is a good pill? Come on now. So, you know, some of these I don't like that much, but this is okay. Monstrous lung, how does it work? Yeah, I like it. We will definitely take this. In fact, you know what? Let's kill ourselves and take a sacrificial dagger. That'll give us a... It'll give us red hearts, which is fine for now. I don't expect to be taking damage, like, at all, so I think we're totally fine to exist on this amount of HP. So let's get Monstro's Lung... Oh, shit! We did it! We blew it! Let's get Monstro's Lung fully charged. I blew it again. Monstro's Lung, get charged up, please. The rate of fire decrease on Monstro's Lung is so bad. There we go! Mind you, when the shots land, they do quite a number. I think it's Monstro's Lung interacting with chocolate milk. The shots don't seem to travel nearly as far either, so maybe we, I wouldn't say we screwed ourselves, but maybe we hurt ourselves a little bit there in doing this. Also, that can happen, though, so I think if you just go with a full charge into a room, that's where the money maker happens. Pretty good. Plus, like, our technology laser. Not really doing that much damage anymore, actually. The flies helping out, though. Yeah, maybe I kind of screwed ourselves ever so slightly here. Okay, I'm just going to blow you up. I'm going to try to blow you up anyway if the game lets me. Mom's pad, huh? Well, we'll pick it up, put it back down so it doesn't show up again. Could fight Blue Baby if we wanted to. I'm kind of questioning why we would want to, though. We're going to fight Greed in here. Greed did drop two chests. Tiny Planet is one of them, and the body is the other. So that will ruin Horror of Babylon, but if we get the I Am Error room, we can trade our HP away anyway. Let's try this shit. I don't even know how this... Oh, man, that seems like it might have screwed me completely. But that's half the fun of it. Our flies... Oh, my God. Our flies, presumably, will help us out. But, yeah, certainly we are weaker than we used to be. All we need now is Proptosis to make this completely shitty. Flies, come on, dog. Am I no longer generating flies because of this weird interaction I've got here? I don't know. I still have high hopes for this one. Just an example of, you know, too many cooks spoiling the broth. Hey, there is a, Spirit Heart back there. I should probably go back and get it. Oh, you know what? My damage is probably just shittier now because of the Horror of Babylon thing. We really need an I Am Error room. Let's go back there. This will give us a charge, but we can get our Spirit Heart that we left behind for reasons unbeknownst. This is getting back into trademark Northern Lion absurdity. I dig it. There's our Spirit Heart. Let's pop it. Ah, perfect. Okay, so we get our Joker card back, and we'll get Bob's Curse, and we'll head up to the next floor. Eventually, they're going to have to give us a deal with the devil that actually is, like, good for us. Six keys. We're running out. Unicorn Stump, Scissors, Rotten Baby's pretty good. Unicorn Stump is occasionally good. Spider Baby only gives you spiders when you get hit, but that might help us out a little bit here in our newly shitty run. And we'll Joker card up again. Yeah, we will totally take all of these. That's going to up our damage a little bit by putting us in Horror Babylon state. We've completely broken the Spoonbender effect. That's pretty much what I'm intending on. So now, instead of being able to stand at the other side of the map and kill enemies, I have to take about, like, 15 seconds to charge up a shot and then stand directly next to them and let weird Monstro's Lung Tiny Planet $3 bill action take place. This is very unusual. But if we can win with this... Well, I was going to say if we can win with this, we can win with anything, but truth be told, our damage is still pretty solid. Just a lot less solid than it used to be. And I don't relish the thought of fighting, like, so many chubs and stuff like that. What is going on? I'm loving this, like, electrical storm.
Surrender and embrace the power of the dark side.
One more room? Maybe pick up some spirit hearts or something in the process? Actually, no, what we need is keys at this point. So if we don't get any keys here, this will be our last cycle, unfortunately. And it's been a trip, that's for sure. Excuse me? We didn't fight Greed in our shop this time? You gave me infestation. Well, I got three keys. That's something. How did I miss this black heart back here? Wow, right in the corner, huh? Alright. Well, we knew that this would... Whoa! Okay. Death's Touch is a good $3 bill effect. Smartfly is good. It's been a 43-minute long run. We should probably end it soon, but... I love these runs. These runs are a lot of fun. If only we had the D6, we'd be in a more ridiculous position, but this one's already pretty freaking crazy. Oh. Doesn't really matter whether we use the keys on this floor or the next floor. Moon card. Number one. I think it makes our range even worse, which is funny. Oh, we're Lord of the Flies now, though. So anytime we run into an enemy that has flies, those flies become ours. That's probably not that important, but hey, we got it. So I guess, like, to charge our shot, we fire at them, and then we turn away at the last second to fire like that. Number one also allows us to get the Monstro's Lung charge a little bit faster. What do you think? To use our unknown charge, our undefined charge, we'll fight Blue Baby to see if it works? I mean, it still does a lot of damage. It's 100% a Monstro's Lung play, though, for sure. That's still really good damage. Oh, we did it! Okay, so we got one Joker card. We've only got one key, so this is kind of like the end of the dream, I think. Unless we get bombs or key. Health up, we don't really want. Paralysis. Pretty fly. We'll take our Joker card, and we'll head up to the next floor. And this is probably going to be the last floor that we're going to do this on, but it's been fun. Hourglass. That's a disappointment. We'll kill this guy, then use the Joker card. I forgot we had Joker. Pretty soon, we'll just end up getting deals with the devil that are, like, exclusively breakfasts. Collar and goat head. I mean, might as well take the collar. It actually provides us with a small benefit. Goat head provides us with nothing. I can't believe we didn't see Mom's Knife or Brimstone, though. Not that we needed to succeed, but like, come on, you know? Come on. I thought we earned it, at least. That worked surprisingly well. Without any more keys, like, the only reason we'd be continuing to do the unknown or undefined is to get more error rooms. Which, you know, that gives us one more item at a time and is fine, but at the same time, come on. We gotta finish this run sometime. Unless we get four more keys. Hey, thanks for the black heart. So I will go to our shop because there's a chance we can blow up a key beggar and get an item, apparently. With one extra... Oh, we got the rosary. That's actually pretty important. With one extra key, we can unknown. I fucking hate this. It's gotta end at some point. But we did just get a tears upgrade. Alright, this is gonna be the last one. This will be the last cycle. I don't want to keep this going for like 2 hours, but it's been a fun run. We can take it. And then Joker. Then take like Judas. Well, we can take them both. Oh, no, we can't. Didn't really matter which one we took. Truth be told, flies, come on, don't waste your lives here. What's the point? Well, certainly it's been a ridiculous run. It's one of maybe the few runs I've ever had where I think I've actually made myself weaker on the chest than stronger, despite having a lot of good items drop, but, you know, certainly it's been ridiculous. And that's half the fun. Or all the fun, sometimes. I wonder if we, like... How are our bombs doing? Just poison? Surprising, we have so few bomb synergies. We're still doing enough damage to basically one-shot with our weird Monstro's Lung Tiny Planet shot, but... That's for you, Dark Bum, but let's be honest, we're probably pretty unlikely to need it. Oh, Mom's Contact here. Get a Keybagger on this one. We've already fought Greed too many times. That's what I figured. Oh, the mind. We can see everything. I can't do it anymore. We gotta end it at some point. I got a life to lead. Let's do this, Blue Baby. You are dead already. That actually was very strong. I don't know why I was thinking it wasn't. But anyway, hey, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. We'll be back with a Samson run next. And I'll see you next time.